Captain Kirk, before you go on, may I make a request?
Yeah.
Can you get those things out of here?
The day after the show closed, I went on the soundstage just like I would walk in here with everybody out of here, and there were tribbles all over the place. I picked up 40 tribbles for no reason other than that they were lying around. I put them in a plastic bag. I took them home.
Have him find Cyrano Jones and hold him. And get these tribbles off the bridge.
I passed them out to the kids in the neighborhood. 20-some-odd years later, I got these kids that are in college, and I decide I'm finding out when I go to these conventions that some of these things are worth $350, $400 that people are getting for the original tribble.
Precisely, and at 6 credits a head, well, that is a body, it mounts up. Now, if you'll excuse me.
So I tried to hustle the kids that I gave them to, and I'd call them up and say, do you still have that tribble that I gave you back when I did? Yeah, Bill, I have it. What do you want? What's up? I said, I'd like to buy it from you because I didn't keep one.
Well, Cyrano Jones says that a tribble is the only love that money can buy.
And the kids would say, now being men, they'd say, who are you putting on? Don't you think we know what a tribble, an original tribble, is worth?
The new Deep Space Nine, all of the Star Treks now, are a different show than the one that Roddenberry did, although I think he would approve of what we're doing.
Yes, the old ones, the ones who made us.
I don't think the real young kids watch our show. They watch Deep Space Nine.
Deep Space Nine, as all this stuff now, because of all the years and all the stuff we've learned to do, is richer in all the technical things. I mean, to work on that set is wild. I mean, you go over and think you can do something with some of those computers. There was none of that on the original show. I think one of the big things why the original show is considered what it is now is because it was so spare.
I am endeavoring, ma'am, to construct a mnemonic memory circuit using stone knives and bearskins.
I'm not sure that we would have continued this kind of popularity, this enduring appeal, had these other shows not come on the air.
And from my observations, it seems they're bisexual, reproducing at will.
As these other shows have been successful, and one after the other, it has given a kind of a glow, a patina, to the original. And as if, you know, the original has spawned these other shows.
I am my own beginning, my own ending.
If we had been the beginning and the end of Star Trek, I think we would have been lost from the public consciousness. And this sense of veneration would never have been created. So when it was really totally antithetical to what I initially believed, because when I heard about Next Generation, I said, well, when that takes off and becomes successful, we'll be totally forgotten.
What happened to the old ones, Ruck?
The opposite has happened. I think as these other shows have achieved success and become more and more popular, it has given the original a certain, you know, sense of importance that it might not otherwise have.
We were together all the time.
I don't remember seeing Gene Roddenberry on the set. But you sure got a sense that you're going to have to answer to Gene.
Gene Roddenberry, I guess, was just, a genius. And though I never met the man, I wish I had.
I went over to see Gene, and he talked about this, and some of the things he said made sense. Others did not make much sense, and I talked to him. I told him a lot of things, all of which Gene very happily not only integrated into the show, but took quality responsibility for. That was one of Gene's most positive qualities. No matter who did what, it wound up in the mythology being Gene who had done it.
So Gene and I ended up with this great rapport because he knew nothing about actors. And he'd just say, what do I do? Who shall I hire? And I'd give him my opinion based on having just read them in the office and say, this is the way I think you ought to go.
Gene Roddenberry collected the greatest writers and helped them along. And even if the writer wasn't so great, he helped them along so that they became great. And that was, I think, one of Gene's better attributes was the fact that he helped people.
And I will always thank the Lord and Gene Coon and Mr. Roddenberry for starting me as the squire. It was really great.